Yeah, that's a vibe. She wanna fight. That's a vibe. It's a vibe, yeah, yeah. Late night. Oh, it's a vibe. Let me slide. Oh, it's a vibe, yeah, yeah. Dim the lights.
Good evening, Vibe Tribe. Good afternoon. Good morning. Whatever time zone that you're in. It's your boy, Rome Boys Robbie. Founder, host, CEO, producer extraordinaire. Here to bring you guys. It's a vibe. Happy Wednesday morning. We are so excited to be live with you guys. What's the deal, Pickles? I hope everything is kosher to everybody out there in YouTube land. Make sure that if you guys have not already, we greatly, greatly appreciate it. If you do what the banner says down below, okay? Go ahead, hit us up on Twitter. Follow us on Twitter at IssaVibePod30. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel right here, okay? The way that you know that it'll happen, that word subscribe, we'll say subscribe, duh, okay? Also, that currently it's a gray button with a thumbs up. Hit that one for us as well, that like button. Help us break this tricky YouTube algorithm. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, if you are catching the live premiere, enjoy the live chat and drop a comment of your favorite segments and jokes below. Let's get into the cast and crew. First up, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to go hard. It's your boy, Javon.
What's good? Another week. We at it. We ready. Ready to vibe out. Let's get it.
Bro, absolutely. Hey, man, before we get into our next panelist, how has your week been, your weekend been, brother?
Man, it was kind of, weird without football for a change, so I ain't know what to do. Shit, got to find myself cleaning up the house.
Oh, shit. Why you put you on chore duty? I feel it.
I just woke up bored. Wasn't nothing to do, really. Just, first weekend without, just cleaned up the house. Went to the park with my daughter. It was just weird having some free time freeing up. So that's good. Hang out with the fam.
I had to pick up hockey.
What, you on ice or are you just on rollers?
No, hockey. Betting. Like betting.
Okay. Yeah. I thought I heard hockey.
I'm not getting
first
on the ice. Yeah, I'm not getting
on ice. I don't discriminate. You never know.
Yeah.
You never know.
Let's get into our very, very next guest. Ladies and gentlemen, can I get a drum roll, please? That was rough. Ladies and gentlemen, Maddie Kroll. What is good, sis?
I missed you guys so much. So much.
It's been a minute.
Yeah, I had such bad FOMO the other day. I was really just like, I almost asked if one of you guys wanted to jump on live, like on Twitter, and just go at it with me because I was so sad. I've had a bit of a week, had a long day today, so I look like a potato with my fro and no makeup. But I have to tell you guys a story. I'm complete with stripper nails. Look at this shit.
Get it.
Oh my gosh. So,
hey, really quick, it's a vibe. We love the strippers.
Stripper nails. I was like, are you
kidding?
Shout
out to James Harden.
I have a job. I am on the board for a very well-known volunteer organization, and I have stripper nails.
Anyway, spicy.
So what had happened was one of the girls that I'm friends with through the volunteer organization made a phone call to get me into her nail salon. So it was like a big deal. I was trying to be like on my best behavior. I like brought my good tipping money. Yeah, I was like pumped to be there because I've been trying to get into the salon. So
like
I show up.
A club?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's like,
this sounds exclusive.
It's selective. Yeah. So it was a big deal that I got in, right?
Okay.
So I picked my color and it was white with just like a little shimmer, like what I normally do. You guys know my nails. I like chill, low key nails, not anything crazy. So I pick out my color. She's doing my nails. I have in my AirPods and I'm watching film because I'm about to do a show with my man Herm. So I've been like kind of catching up on film. So I was deep in it. You guys know how you get when you watch film. So I'm watching film on my iPad. I look up, three coats in, freaking, it was straight glitter. I was like, I couldn't say anything. I was supposed to be like, oh, my best behavior.
Carry glitter.
She was like, do you like? And I was like, yeah, I love them. Like, they're beautiful. I'm going to have to go back in like a week and get them fixed.
And I'm like, so.
Oh, my God.
I said white. Hey. You do not know white? out of glitter. So.
I was just come like, I was just happy to be there. And so I just went with it. So
how much that cost? About $60, $70? How my nails cost?
Oh, no. No, hey, they're not that expensive.
I feel that though. Like I mean, my barber that I go
$10 less.
My homie Ian, he's a very tough chair to get into. He always, you know, hits me up ahead of time. He's like, "Yo, you need a cut? You know, I'm taking cuts." And always fits me in. He's like he's one of the top rated barbers in Colorado, top five, dead or alive right now. So I mean, I feel it how tough it is when you're like, oh shit, like.
You got to get in.
He messes
up your lines. You just fucking roll with it.
Oh, I mean, hey, my homie don't ever play around Big Poppy Waves over here rocking a Caesar. But, you know,
do look good, though.
Thank you. You know what? Hey, let's start off today's show. Cheers to me. Cheers to you. The Vibe Tribe, what it do. We appreciate you guys. Keep subscribing. We are just about 50-ish subscribers away from 200. We're about 50-ish watch hours from 400 total watch hours since the channel's been alive. And you guys, shout out to you guys.
Turn up.
3,000 plus views. We are just around the corner of 4,000 views. So make sure you guys share this content on all of your social media. Dilly dilly. All right. Let's set this one off. This is like super inspired by you, Maddie, from your Twitter this weekend.
So, my Twitter. Somebody messaged me and said, "Never mind."
Maddie might become a two-sport analyst after this fucking weekend.
Basketball's sexy,
ladies and gentlemen. And we're gonna start off with you on this perspective, Maddie, because clearly you were freaking tuned in. What makes the NBA All-Star Game more marketable and entertaining than the NFL Pro Bowl? These two events did happen about a week and a half or two apart. The two essentially serve the same purpose for the players, but for the fans, there is a very big disparity in ratings. Why do we think that is, and how do we think that maybe one or the other side could fix the other? Maddie.
So I feel like, I mean, you kind of said it right there. I think it's more marketable because it's more entertaining. And it's more entertaining because these guys actually play ball. Like, it's fun. They actually go out and ball out. Watching the Pro Bowl, people are scared to get hurt. Like, first of all, if we want to get down to the nitty-gritty, the NFL contracts are bullshit. Give them some guaranteed contracts, and then they might go out and actually play. But these guys are scared to get hurt because if they can't play next season or they have a contract year coming up, they can't go all out because that's fucking with their money. And in the NBA, it doesn't really matter because their money's guaranteed. They can leave a team, go somewhere else and get paid, and it doesn't matter. Guaranteed money. So if we want to get down to the nitty-gritty, that's what it's about.
No, you're right. I mean,
and also we saw so many big players that didn't get to play. Nobody in the Super Bowl got to play, which is how it goes. Wait, what?
He said Super Bowl.
No, I said nobody that played in the Super Bowl gets to play in the Pro Bowl.
Oh shit. Fuck. Yeah. God damn it. Yeah.
Yep.
I've been drinking. Hold on, me too. Well, go
ahead. I love that we were on the same vibe there.
Facts. Hot sauce.
But also, like, I mean, I love football. I said this on my – this is a tweet you're talking about. I love football, but basketball is so sexy. I mean, Steph just out there draining him. And I was like, it's just so smooth. And, like, it flows. Everybody's getting into it. But you get to see all the big superstars. And then we get the past greats that were there. Both MJs. I mean, I'm not going to get all into it. But damn.
Basketball, you know, they more catered to the culture before NFL. It's really that. You know, basketball, you hit a lot of hip hop, you know, that's who on the court, a lot of fans there, you know, mixed in, you know, but even there, a lot of people there listen to hip hop, you know, new age kids, all that. So they already catered the game to the culture.
Yeah.
And All-Star Weekend, you see nothing but the culture out there, you know. So it's just fun to watch. It's entertaining. And NFL, you know, it's only so much you can do on the football field. You know, you got to get people there. And, you know, Pro Bowl, maybe just like somebody said, it just needs to be flag football, I guess. You know, they'll go out there and do that.
They're
you
not
know, they might look better.
Yeah.
Hold on.
You're right, because in some of their contracts, you can't ride a bike. You can't do certain things because Ben Roethlisberger got hurt on a bike or something. So in the contract, they put stuff like that. So, yeah, it's Josh really Norman wild. And your money not even guaranteed.
And like everyone flipped out. They were like, what if you got hurt? And he was like, but I didn't. He's like, I jumped over a running, raging bull wearing all red. He's like, I'm okay. But like, still, like, yeah, you like, and that was a void of his contract technically, but because he didn't get hurt, there was no penalty.
Well, it's stupid enough to where like they have to register if they're training. So it's just like what we dealt with this off season. Like, you get hurt off of the facilities, like outside the facilities, and your contract's voided. Yeah. Like, you guys know I'm friends with a couple of guys in the league, and we were out on the lake and I had my phone out and they're like, what the fuck are you doing? Put that away. Like, no one gets, you can't even be out on a boat like that if there's like tubing or anything like that going on. It's wild.
John Wall.
he's like, you about to get me in trouble. Slick.
Yeah. Put that shit away. And I was
John
like,
Wall.
Yeah. Cause Roger Goodell's on my Snapchat.
When he was with the Washington Wizards.
You are hot shit, Maddie.
When John Wall was with the Washington Wizards, he had slipped and fell in the shower, and you know, the typical standing showers, like you know, the one of those, and had ended up rupturing his Achilles in the process, thus resulting in him having to miss a very big portion of the season. I think this was back in, I want to say maybe 2018, 2019, if I'm correct. Don't quote me on that one. You guys let me know down in the comments.
Robbie's like, don't fact check me.
No, dude, let me know down in the comments. That generates more comments if I'm wrong or something. But and he had still gotten paid out, you know, and that's an NBA contract. Maddie, I brought up a very valid point with the guaranteed contracts and such. How many prior veteran retired NBA players do we know that they're living for the most part fairly well, but then how many former retired NFL athletes that we know that it is a very drastic difference.
It's completely different.
Two totally completely different worlds.
And just the benefits are so much better. Oh, in the league, like, they're after the league care, it's terrible. Like, we're asking these guys to put their bodies on the line every single snap. And what do they get to show for it?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, there's guys who can't remember their kids' names. Yep. They can't walk. That's why.
Sports like football, boxing, and MMA, I feel like should be at the top of the line in regards to how we look at healthcare. And I'll even put hockey up there too, in terms of how we look at healthcare, CTE, things of that nature.
Soccer, right, too. They say soccer, because they hitting it
Hitting the ball.
Soccer ball a lot. Mm-hmm.
Yep, and even heads collide during that a lot as well. I think that when it comes to – hell, we'll just put athletics, you know, there in general. But, I mean, we should probably be looking at a different better and benefit. When it comes to a sport like football, there are some amazing things that we could do on a football field, and there are some pretty cool plays that can be drawn up, especially for the fan point of view. We were seeing Steph Curry pull up half-court shots. Like, someone
insane.
That could have
easily
– yeah, like someone that could have easily dunked is dumping it back to Steph Curry because they know that he's going to make it, and they know that it's going to boost ratings, and they know that the crowd's going to go wild. Yo, when whatever quarterback that's in the Pro Bowl back there drop back, have Kirk Cousins hit a perfect dime that's perfectly caught for a one-handed Odell style catch, you know, make some of those crazy
just,
things happen. Like,
it's just different, bro. Well, you can be like, hey, 1-on-1 with him real quick on the basketball court real quick. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'll start getting like, hey, clear out.
Yo,
like,
did you
so
see?
So it's all type of stuff, man. It's
did
just
you see
so
Michael
much,
Jordan
bro.
You see, did you see the clip of Michael Jordan challenging Magic?
He
says, right here, right now, you and me one-on-one. Oh, I got chills.
You know, this dude been practicing too.
Bro, he's still who? You know, he's still, he probably go out there every little, but you know, they athletes, so a lot of them gotta wake up, you know, get they body going. So they gotta do a little something.
Remember that clip of Spud Webb. For those who don't know, for all the youngins out there, Spud Webb was a basketball player, stood at about a height of about 5'6", okay? Won a dunk contest, one of the most famous dunk contests ever, at the height of 5'6", okay? To dunk on a NBA regulation rim at 5'6".
That's shorter than me.
It's mind-blowing. At the age of 56, this man did it in dress shoes still. Like, I was like, oh my goodness. And he was just messing around. He was
but
like,
that's what I'm saying. Like we
got them bunnies. Just like,
oh, you want me to go? You got them bunnies. Jeez.
That's what's up.
Go ahead, Maddie.
Yeah, man.
No, I also feel like for me, it might have just been different just because I've been so deep into football. And, like, I was catching games here and there, but it was just so fun to see, like, all the superstars. Like, all of them were right there.
Yeah. Yeah. It was crazy to see generations cross and generations accept each other of that sport. To see the old guard and, like, kind of that middle era. I think it's special the way that the retired players treat the current players, like you know, the freshly retired guys. I think that's interesting. It was just overall the way they put on that production is just better. The way they market that is a lot better. The way they draft those teams is a lot better. NFL, I guess, take a book out of the NBA's, you know, like page. Because the Pro Bowl is becoming a dying aspect of the whole entire season.
Bro, they gotta fix, or they just gotta name to it and have something else, bro, and do something else. Mm-hmm. Like just like this the Pro Bowl team, and not even play, just like just the Pro Bowl team. Y'all made it, and then do something else.
Make a ceremony.
Because what you're putting on the field, what I seen in the highlights of the Pro Bowl, that ain't it.
Juju's challenging all NFL athletes to TikTok battles for Pro Bowl rights. There we go. Have you guys heard about, so obviously festival season is coming up, right? I obviously said some words that made someone excited. Festival season, concert season.
Is that me? My dog's also messing around with his bone.
Oh no, you're good. You're good. I'm sorry. It was just perfect timing the way that the sound came in.
Oh no, I said oof. If that's what you were talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we have festival season / concert season coming into play now. I don't know if you guys heard about this. Coachella's going completely mask off. No mask mandate. As long as you're pretty much like updated, it's to my knowledge. From what I read, they're treating it as if the world is moving on and is continuing. I want to make sure I choose this carefully because we are on YouTube, and I don't want to do a censorship. But what are you guys feeling about this? Like no mask thing? Would you be attending Coachella or any other festivals? I know my answer to this question, Javar. Concerts, festivals, this season's coming. What's your thoughts?
Oh, you ain't gonna catch me out of none of them. I got too much stuff to do. I'm really not a huge concert guy. But people was gonna go regardless, you know. So it's more the person. They read the guidelines, rules, and regulations, and if they want to go pay their money, they can go have fun. Toodles to them, you know. So, you know, hopefully everybody's safe and do what they have to do. But, you know, this is going to come eventually. Some states open up sooner than others. So we here. We at it, man. So let's see how the numbers roll after
the concert. My thing is if Coachella does it, you know that every other major festival is going to do, like, EDC's right around the corner. And, like, that's in Vegas, or, I mean, depending on which one you go to.
I was going
to
say, I went in Mexico.
You went to one of Mexico? Oh, my gosh.
It was unreal.
I hope that you have
stories. I could feel the music in my, like, I could feel it in my body, like, a couple days after. And I don't, I didn't do drugs or anything, like, nothing. Like, I hadn't even, at that point, I didn't even drink. So, because I was 20 and I didn't take my first sip till I was 21. So, yeah, like, completely sober. I felt it in my body a couple days later.
High school ruined that.
Felt it in my bones.
All right. So, Jabbar, really quick, if you've never felt 10,000 watts of bass just trembling through your body,
it literally makes your body shake. You feel like you're, like, levitating. It feels like you're high. Like, I had never experienced being high before, but, like, that's what it feels like. But you're, like, I was dead sober. And I felt like, now looking back, like, I felt like I do when I'm high.
I'm all jacked up on Mountain Dew, Chip.
It is one of just the most beautiful, life-changing experiences.
I definitely wouldn't do it, like, now, though. Like, one, I feel like I'm too old for it. Like, past my bedtime, cutting into my beauty sleep, like, all of the things. But and also, like, it was just, like, it was the scene that I was in. Like, I was modeling. I was overseas. I was with, like, a bunch of hot girls. Like, we were, like, it was that lifestyle. You know what I mean? So, like, I felt cool. If I went now, I'd be like, damn it. Like, I want some snacks. Too many people around me. Like, I'm not trying to get down on a porta potty. Like, I hate, like, you can't sit down on the pot. It's just, like, all of the things. But as far as the mask goes, Coachella's, like, a big cootie festival anyway, so nobody gives a shit.
Exactly. You know what I mean? It is Coachella. Like, this is Coachella that we're talking about.
Yeah. Those are my thoughts. Robbie's laughing at me.
So, here's what I will say. I live in the base capital of the world, at least of North America. I know that there's a lot of our international followers. Like, I know I have, like followers out down in Australia. They're like, crikey, mate. You want to debate that? Like, because, you know, they that hard style scene down there and that Melbourne shuffle, that if y'all don't know how to shuffle your feet, I'm sorry.
He's always got to dance. Can I just point out one thing?
Oh, I can dance.
I made one comment about your accent on Twitter the other day, and you were like, ah! And look at you talking about Aussie accents up here.
Like, because, all right, so I was with somebody.
Jabbar, tell me when you read that, you didn't read hashtag odd.
So I was with someone. I was actually riding in the car when I had read that, and I was with someone who watches this show, and she literally goes, she's like, see? That's exactly why she's my favorite cast member. That right
Hell
there.
Hell yes. Like, love her.
She's like, because she'll call you out on your bullshit. And she's like, she fucking gets it. She's like, you talk like that. You talk exactly like that. I was like, no, I don't. Read it. And she's like, yeah, you do. And I was like, ah.
I don't talk like that.
Ah. But no, like, for real. Like, I'm an outdoorsy person. June 14th is my birthday. Born in the summertime. 2 days after Pop, like, I'm all for outdoors activities. I'm all for live music, outdoor concerts. I'm going to be one of those people that, single, taken, no matter what, like, I'm always going to be at some concert, some festival. Yeah, like, I'm always going to be at some concert, some festival, some live music show. The bars I go to usually have a band or something playing, or like karaoke or something. I just love music. I love art. And there's no better way to experience it than just like, hey, we ain't got the kids for a weekend. Let's go get it. Or, you know, we ain't got no kids. Let's go get it. Like, you know, so yeah. That's all I'm saying. And it's an experience too. It's an experience. If you're dating someone and you're serious, it's an experience to go experience music. You know, like I said, 10,000 watts of bass up close. Hotel room afterwards, yeah.
Or your significant other can go. They can have a great time, be hungover for a week, and you can stay at home and do masks and not have anybody fucking talk to you for a weekend and relax and eat what you want, watch what you want. That's my type of weekend.
Play video games.
Yeah. Oh.
But see, you have to have a weekend that breaks up that That's another weekend. Like, you could do that for, like,
homie, no, like the crowd anxiety like that. Nah, I think I'm past that part. Like, I could do big crowds to go to like the Super Bowl or something like that. You know what I mean? But I'm not trying to go to EDM festivals anymore. I can't.
I could do it all. You know, I'd have been to events in Atlanta, you know, large crowd. So eventually I'd probably do something like that.
If Atlanta brings back Freaknik.
Not happening. You feel me? They trying to make too much happening. Money. That's not the crowd they trying to draw, Robbie. That's not the crowd they're trying to draw there, Robbie.
Go to the edge of the circle.
You feel me? When they tried to redo it, they shut that down quick.
Hey, if that
Jabbar, I just realized how nice you look tonight.
Thank you.
Two thoughts. One, great color on you. Second thought, beautiful teeth. Just beautiful teeth. Great smile.
Hey, I've been working hard my whole life for these teeth.
Brushing those. Your mama beat that into you, didn't she?
Oh, Lord.
Yeah, I brush every morning, you know.
You say
why she got...
You're going to start flossing.
I got to floss. Time, but...
Nah, you got to floss.
When I feel something, then I floss now.
Oh no, you got to floss. Listen, y'all need to get this is Good we are not is sponsored yet, but yet. Cocoa Floss. If you guys have not tried Cocoa Floss, and I know people are gonna think I'm bougie for this, but it is infused with coconut oil, it's soothing to your gums, it doesn't cut up. You know how like sometimes when you floss it kind of cuts your gums when you go?
Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's comfortable, it gets stuff out, your breath has never smelled better. I'm telling you, Cocoa Floss. It's the way to go. There's all different flavors. It's
where phenomenal. Do you find this?
I have, you can get it online. You can get it at Target. We sell it at my dental office is where I get it. But I have just like my hot sauce. Anywhere I have hot sauce, I got my floss. I got my purse floss. I got my backpack floss, my car floss, my locker floss. I got my home floss, all of the things. Why are you laughing at me?
I'm not. I went
on a tangent. Shit.
No. All right, because I'm the same way. Like I'm the same way. So
people
like,
are probably like, it's so nice when she's gone because they actually stay on track. I watched your show, it was so short, and I was like, damn, I'm the talker.
No, we're well in our time right now. But no, like I do the same thing though, because it's something about a person that takes care of themselves.
It's also that, like it makes like taking care of yourself feels good.
Oh, it feels so good. When I look at myself in the mirror, goddamn, I'm like, thank you, mommy and daddy. I appreciate it. I'm so thankful you didn't pull out that night, motherfucker. Thank you so much. Thank you, Dad.
I think Robbie just told people he was a mistake.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Shit, my daddy was 22, my mom was 17. Yes. Not planned. I changed both my parents' life.
Oh, yeah, I wasn't planned either.
For the better. Let's keep this one moving. All right, Maddie, this is your turn right here. So before we get into this, Lil Sis has been letting us know, you know, I got something for Tuesday. So everybody, right here with me, strap in. It is Maddie's topic of the week. Take it away, sis.
That intro just gave me chills. Yes. Okay. So now I have to follow that up after that bomb intro. I just feel like I want to take this opportunity, this platform, and I'm very disappointed that Amar is not here because Amar needs to hear this. And he's going to get it on the replay, but this is just genuine education. So I want to talk about friends with benefits. Let's talk about some ground rules. What needs to happen to make a successful, enjoyable friends with benefits situationship? Okay. I had to educate one of my friends. I had to educate another brother. It's just... this is stuff that people need to know from both ends. Okay. In no particular order. This is just kind of the things that I discuss. First of all, dudes. I'm talking directly to the dudes right now. You are going to get your nut. So if you're going to get your nut, make sure your girl does too. damn, ain't nothing worse than wasting your body count on a brother that has bad dick. That's rule number one. If you're gonna do it, put your effort into it. And it that okay, second topic. I hope Robbie's okay over there. I probably should have prepped you guys for some of these. Second topic. I can't even concentrate. Okay, there's a difference between a fuck buddy and a friends with benefits. If you want a fuck buddy, that's when you show up, you pull down your pants, you fuck, and then you leave. Or like
exactly. You call them when you're drunk in, from the car.
Get in, get out, no hoopla. If you're friends with benefits, that means you have to be a friend. And this is where I got into it with my homie the other day. I was like, bro, listen, no, like you're wrong. He was in there saying, like, she's trying to text me throughout the day, text me about the All-Star game. Well, hell yeah. Like,
you're my friend.
You talk to your friends about shit like that.
I talk to you.
And like, that's the thing is I had a straight on conversation with him and he was like, nah, she's going to get mixed signals. What, you send him mixed signals? No. Here's the thing, dudes, and I'm talking directly to the dudes. A girl who knows she's in a friends with benefits situation is not going to text you about her drama. She's got the dudes that are friend zoned that want to fuck her are listening to her drama, are listening to her work shit. She's not bothering the dude that she's fucking with that. She's trying to be cool with you, like you're friends, right? So do shit together. Like you can go out, you can grab coffee, you can go out and grab a couple of drinks, you can just hang out, watch movies together, whatever. But like you gotta be a friend. If you're wanting a fuck buddy where you don't have to fuck with, then get a fuck buddy. But if you're gonna be friends with benefits, like treat her like she's a person, right? She's your friend. You gotta be a friend, and you can't just ghost because you think she's maybe catching feelings. And that brings me to my next point. Well, let me circle back. Girls, don't blow your friends with benefits up with your drama. He don't want to hear that shit. You got girlfriends for that, okay? You got sisters, you got moms, you got other friends. The dudes that are not fucking you, they're trying, so they're gonna listen to your bullshit. Go to them. But like, don't dump.
Oh my god, we're doing this topic.
Free game.
Your friends with benefits. Okay. Now we're going to the next one. Are you taking notes, Robbie? You should
be. Oh, no, I'm good. I'm making sure I'm doing this so that the other motherfuckers out there, that's the equivalent of the note emoji at the end of a tweet or something. Y'all need to be out. She's spitting. Go ahead. Go.
I'm spitting this out because people need to hear this.
Mm-hmm. Yes, doctor.
Yes, doctor. I can't. Okay. So I forgot where I was at. What?
No, you talk about girls don't blow them up with the drama and da 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 da.
Oh yeah, don't blow them up. But dudes, check in on her, treat her like she's a person, text her. If like everybody's scared, like oh, she's probably catching feelings, blah blah blah, because all you guys are out there cocky because you're getting a girl and it's non-committal, and it's like it blows up a dude's head because he's getting some and it's non-committal, but like. It is your responsibility as a person, no matter what side of this situationship that you're on, that you communicate expectations and feelings along the way. It is your responsibility to check in. Hey, is this still good with you? You still good with this? Us just doing this non-committal, blah, blah, blah. That is your responsibility. If you're say worried amen. That somebody might be getting the wrong idea about it, that's your fault.
Church,
don't be a douche and ghost. Like, I hate that shit. Like, talk to her, check in on her, you know, like, whatever. Just don't ghost. Don't be that person.
No.
Questions. I'm opening it up for questions.
Hold on. Before we even get into questions, Maddie say, here's a left and a right and a left and a right and a left. And in the first round, they go down. Oh, my. Yo, you. Here's the thing. If you've been following us for 21 episodes, this is a big piece of, and a big piece of the conversation we've been leading up to. And if you've really been following, and we've been getting these advice columns and shit, like if you really listen, like there's real. Jabbar said it while Maddie was free game. Y'all remember Don't Be a Menace while drinking gin juice in the hood or whatever the name is. Y'all remember message. Hey, that right there, message. That's one that you screen record, you save in your gallery,
That's one that is like, yo, if I'm feeling down about my situation, I don't know what the fuck I need to do. You go back, you replay that right there. You go back, you replay that right there. Look, at the 2850 mark is when we got into that topic. That's, I'm letting everyone know in the chat because that's your viral moment. That speech right there, that's it. I can't debate you on anything that you said.
Because it's all like facts. This.
I don't have.
There's no debate, but just like on topic one. Yeah, I mean, everybody got to show up first off. Yeah. You know, the guy treated like, you know, you got several shots in you. So, you know, if you come up short the first time, the second time, be on point. Make sure all parties enjoy. You know, y'all slip up that first time. You know, you get to redeem yourself, hopefully. So you got a two or a three or whatever, but, you know, at least two. So redeem yourself the second time. And for everybody in the party, you got to do your part.
Yeah,
you can't just be one person humping and pumping. You know what I'm saying? So do your little thrust, whatever you got to do together. It makes magic. Just one person can't just be laying there and let the other person do some work. You can take a break at times. It's okay to take that break at times. It's like a sport. It is a sport, right? Is it the best sport? Okay. But you take a break every, you know, everybody need their break, their little 30 seconds, but you got to come back and pump with the team. It makes magic.
With the team. I want a shirt that says hashtag pump with the team.
Hashtag pump with the team. Yo, and in the address, so my rant was just about the dating and the friend with benefits part. Like, if you can't get those other pieces down, and which is just a communication, the trust, and, you know, the having the conversations back and forth type shit, which is, that's just vocal. That's just.
That's any relationship.
Yeah, that's any relationship. That, you know, your fucking is definitely going to be off. Your fucking is definitely going to be off. And I'm going to let y'all know, okay? Now maybe, you know, hey, listen. Yo, papi, tu papi, you know, soy Dominicano, y Jamaican. You know, I got a little bit of rhythm. I got a little bit of sauce up in me, you know? So I'm saying, you know, hey, but I'm going to let y'all know. Sex is all about rhythm, too. How are you going? You can't have, if you got rhythm.
They're stuck on rule number one.
We're going back and we address rule number one. I made sure I spoke passionately first.
I'm ready to talk about rule number two.
I spoke passionately first. But here's what I'll say about rule number one, because Jabbar reminded me about rule number one. If you off rhythm, if you can't dance or whatever, you know, like, you gotta be on rhythm. You gotta be in syncopatico with your partner. You got to know what your partner likes. Take that time. This is where conversation is also important. If you do the other steps, if you do all the other following rules, then what we addressing right now, you're not even going to have an issue, because you're going to know what she's going to like. You're going to know what she's into. You're going to know she's into that, you know, to foreplay. She ain't in the foreplay. She's like, yo, no, hurry the fuck up. Rip my shit off and get the fuck out of here, you know? Like, then, all right, cool. Like, but you got to have those conversations. You got to feel your partner out. And you got to know what your partner's into. And that happens through conversation. If you ain't willing to have a conversation, there ain't no need to get in anticipation and waiting to get into that lovemaking. You already know what I'm saying. That's keep it playing. Push a pee.
Nah, see what it be. It's like, oh, they know, they understand. So you don't have that conversation, when in actuality, you should just be more open. Like, the situation, like, hey, I'm openly looking for positions to any state. I may be moving to any moment, you know what I'm saying? I'm looking to further up my career. I'm looking for change.
Have,
you know,
this
just
conversation.
Be, right. We ought to just be open about it. And if you're in a situation and you feel like you want more, or you having feelings, it's okay to, you know, bring out that feelings to the other party. They may turn the other party away. Cool.
Yeah.
But that's protecting yourself, and you're gonna be better off than getting, you know, keep putting yourself in a hole. And two parties don't feel so way. So whatever, as long as you tell your side, and if they cool with it and they change a little bit, then, you know, hey,
and this, you gotta
person
be honest,
respects
with
me, right? You
now with the,
so you gotta respect yourself. So
now with the protection of your feelings, though, I want to make sure that I really, 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 really speak to the brothers out there. Listen, kings, all right, protecting your feelings is completely 100% circumstantial. Know when and where. It's a chess move, okay? Don't protect your feelings and block yourself off from something that may be very healthy and may be very beneficial for you, just because you may not have been used to that because, you know, oh, well, you know, red flag from this shorty or red flag from that shorty. You can't penalize, you know, or you know, whatever your case would be, you can't penalize your current partner, your current significant other over the repercussions, the consequences. You can't bring in consequences and repercussions to something brand new, you know. So protecting your feelings, I want to make sure that we address what Javar said there. That's very, you know, loosely interpret that. Don't damage something that's good just because you may not be used to it, just because you may not be cultured to it, just because, you know, you may grow up.
That's all about being open. That's all about being open.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, exactly.
I'm doing this because of I'm this way. As long as you're open, you address it, like, you know.
I don't think
and that's a part about communication. The other part should be like, yo, you feeling kind of, you know, weird about the situation. Then another person come out and be like, yeah, my last situation is. So that's what you just come out and talk about.
Yeah, and no, it's better to get it out there. But I also feel like I don't want people to not say something because they're scared that it might push the other person away if they're feeling like it can be a friends with benefits situation and you could catch feelings and say like, hey, like I might want more. Where are you at on this? And like they have the opportunity to tell you. And that's better than to like hide things or lead somebody on or make them that nothing ends well when you're not honest. And I also want to point out like there's a difference between like when I talk about like fuck buddy and friends with benefits, like we talked about the difference, like fuck buddies don't last. Friends with benefits are possible, but fuck buddies are not. You talk about a fuck buddy because guess what? Like she like I'm speaking from a girl point of view because, like, I'm in this situation. Like, I don't need a dude, right?
No.
But
I don't need a girl. I don't need a woman.
If I have to invest my time in something, like, I want it to be more than just physical because I can get that somewhere else. You know what I mean?
Talk that shit, queen.
Yeah. And if you're going to ignore me and treat me like shit, like, no, that's not what this is. Like, you can, like, the friends with benefits last because you respect, you it's communicate. And everything's
open. You basically date. You date.
You're date. You're well, basically date. You're basically together.
It's a non-committal. Yeah. But it doesn't have to be as pressured of like dating, you know? It's just like.
Say amen.
But you're friends. You know what I mean? Like. Yeah. But yeah.
It's called. So friends with benefits, what a lot of people leave out. It's all about respecting the other two. You know what I'm saying?
Respecting the boundaries.
Even, you know, when you're not friends with benefits and you get it on, it's still a degree of respect, you know, there too, but you know, it's just not as much as, hey, what's up? How you going? It's them 2 a.m. text you up. Are you trying to hang out? You know what I'm saying? More so y'all don't really talk about that.
You
want to
go
yeah.
chill.
You
right.
go
and there's a reason those don't work out, but it's also important to like come through for your person too. Like,
oh,
like if you know what I mean? Like you can't just like ghost.
You teach us. Hold on. This is a perfect learning lesson. All of our followers on Twitter, remember when we had family movie night, which we're gonna find another family movie night. The last one happened very organically.
I need you to watch this.
Yeah, it's just gonna happen, but we're gonna clue you guys in. Make sure you're following us on Twitter, like the banner says down below. Like, comment, and subscribe here on YouTube. But Maddie, what did you teach us through that movie? What was a big lesson? It's all about being there for your person, correct?
Mm-hmm. If I tell Javar I'm showing up for something, I'm not fucking him. But guess what? I'm going to show up and I'm going to be there. Or exactly. I'm honest like I can't. But I'm not just going to ignore him until I need something from him. That's the same thing with friends with benefits, right? You got to treat your significant other, and I say significant other in a friends with benefits situation. You got to treat your other partner in that situation with the same respect that you would treat your homies with your boys. Like, you know your dude's going to be mad as hell if the only time you come around is whenever you're trying to get some of his weed or trying to hang out, get his Netflix login, whatever.
Either weed or either it's weed or money or, you know, you only want to show when we're drinking.
Sex is the same thing.
Or, you know,
yeah.
You only wanna, yeah. Like what people don't realize, because sex is such an intimate exchange of pleasures, is that there are other pleasures out there that can fulfill those things. So, you know, and what people don't realize about relationships is that relationships are manifested on many different levels, whether that be business, whether that be friendships, whether that be acquaintances or associates. So there's a key to playing each relationship because there's levels to everything. You know, so I'm not, it comes down to point blank, period, when you're in a friends with benefits situation. if you're not gonna, I'm not gonna play my homies. If I have enough respect for you as my shorty, and you're my shorty, you're my top of my roster, and I'm not having any other sexual partners, mm-hmm. and you're the person that I'm at the end of the day, whether it's every day or whatever the case,
that you're investing your time in.
Exactly. You know, I have to make sure that I, and because that encounter and because that pleasurable is so serious, you know, almost as if you were to exchange money with somebody, how serious is when money falls apart, when business falls apart? That shit gets deep. Crime of passion takes place over that. We know this. So just imagine when you are exchanging your soul and your body with somebody, that shit is deep. It's a deep bond. I have invested something with you. So when we talk about that, it's just important to have super solid communication, very fluid communication, respect that person's time, respect that person's wants and needs. And I think
it's show up. And what Maddie said, women don't be afraid to speak up. Like, hey, bro, hey, last time you
dudes out
hey,
there,
hey, bro, last time I don't know what you doing, but that wasn't it. Hey, show up like that one out time.
Dudes out there, hey, you know what I'm saying? Be a big step.
I already know my best friend, she be straight to me. She be like, these dudes be tripping. Like,
yeah,
I can just go to the grocery store. And recruiting, like, you need to show up. Like, this ain't no thing. Like, for real. So, and dudes don't even know. They be thinking, no, don't be afraid to let them know. Like, hey, bro, you ain't show a lot of time. Don't let it happen again.
Hey, fellas, I'm gonna tell you straight up. Because
I used to be embarrassed. I used to be like, I'm about to go in here. Hey, I need to show up. I don't want her talking bad about me next time.
I've seen in person. Check this shit out. I'm gonna take it to a very deep level with y'all, fellas. Women grew up playing with what? Barbies, right? You know what the best part about Barbie was? How easy it was for her to be able to switch her Ken. Her roster, well, you will always be replaceable on her roster, my G. You are not permanent. Like, unless you are married, or you're in a relationship, like, if you're just friends with benefits, you are not permanent. So don't be walking around like God Almighty. Because listen, you fuck around, lose your spot, you're gonna be butthurt listening to Drake.
I also want to kind of reiterate, this all ties back to rule number one, right? If you're having this open communication, if you have respect for the other person, if you're trying not to give her a shit dick, that was probably bad words
there. See, I was always different. Go ahead, then I want to say something about the
yeah. I know shit dick yeah. is something so else, by the way.
It's important to know what makes that person, what that person wants, right? Like, you got to express expectations, like, and things like that. But I'm just going to shoot y'all straight. I'm just going to get into it. Dudes, like, there's got to be some buildup, right? Don't just go in and jump into it. Nobody's having a good time at that point. I promise
don't
you.
Don't hype yourself up if you know that you're not good.
So what you mean? What you mean? Like, not going to you to my like
you can't just make out, straight, rub yeah. on. Kiss her. Like, touch right, her. Like, flirt hold a little on. Bit. Get
see if you can do a field check. See if you can do a field check.
Yeah.
From an intimate standpoint, hold on.
Flash, waterfall. It's time.
From an intimate standpoint.
Oh, it's dry. It's not time. You know, go down there and do a field, a temperature check real quick.
You can't just, like, jump in.
No,
you're ready to go. We're hot as fuck. Like, of course you can get it up. Good no. for you. But, like, you it's tell. More than that for a girl.
Bong, like, soon as you whisper in the ear, bong. Like, what yeah. is that? I don't know. I didn't know.
I'm going to say this. And I want to know from the homies out there. Y'all can comment, drop a comment or whatever. Fellas, let me know if I'm wrong. But we can tell if a shorty is good with the down below. Just off the way that she kissed and off the way that she worked her tongue when she kissed. Ladies, if y'all can't tell that I may not be the most intimate match for you, despite how attractive you may be towards me, and then I fuck around and disappoint you, that's your fucking fault. You chose it. Like, you didn't catch on to the warning sign.
I think my point is that for it to be like, okay, you guys have made this agreement to, like, be friends and then exclusively like do this in a sexual manner. And I say exclusively because most friends with benefit situation, you're exclusive. It's just, you're not dating. Right. And so you've already made this kind of commitment to like, you've basically, you've committed yourself to getting good sex. That's your job. That is what you are delivering that no one else in the world is giving the other person is good sex. So what is good sex? That is strictly dependent on the other person, right?
That is a definition between the two of you.
So yes. And so like ladies,
you can get as kinky or as vanilla as you want to.
Okay. Pass the kinky sex.
Like, always go kinky.
We like, okay. let me get this out. So like as girls, we like to be kissed. We like the buildup. We like to be touched. We don't want to just like.
What about sexing? Isn't a lot of sexing involved? I mean, sexing.
Sometimes I don't like to do that. I'm not trying to have that on my. And I don't have time for that, right? Like I'm out living my life. But when you
I'm not trying to.
And I'm relaxing. I want to be cuddled up. Like I want to do like the cute cuddling and all of that. Like I want to feel like I got a dude there. If I'm having you only over, I don't want to feel lonely while you're here. So like, let's cuddle. Like we're going to be cute when we're together. But like, I also know like, okay, at the end of it, like ladies, give him a massage, scratch his head a little bit, give him something relaxing. That's his idea of cuddling. He doesn't want to cuddle your ass, but he's doing it because he knows that you like it, you know? So give him a little something he likes. If he doesn't like massages, I don't know any guy that doesn't like a massage. Give him a little head scratch, massage.
Every athlete loves massages.
Because guess what? Like, you are there to be, like, you're there to have some type of situationship with that person, right? You're there to make them feel good, to be a release, whatever. So do that. Make it enjoyable for them to be around you. And amen. I promise you, it'll be a lot more successful.
Amen. The more enjoyable it is to be around you, the quicker you move up on the roster and the more I'm able to spend time with you and I'm more willing to spend time with you. Absolutely. Really quick, I want to say this to the fellas, though. If you do know that you are good at, if you do know that first time you are that motherfucker that really does just come through more powerful than a black power fist, okay, if you are one of those, be very careful. Do not showcase everything first night. If you can get away with giving away what you can give away, then give away what you can give away. If you know that you might turn her into a clinger, just protect yourself, all right?
Hey, I used to be savage out there. I used to be like, bro, you made me go a while. Hey, I'm trying to bring the A game. I'm trying to put your life up. I'm trying. Hey, next week, you think about me, you're going
to take
me.
I'm trying to snatch your soul. I'm trying to snatch your soul every time.
You trying to play games. You want to miss text message, phone calls. Oh, you always busy. Okay, I'm trying to fuck up your life. What was I doing before him? Oh my goodness.
Javar, you ever make a call for work, bro?
Oh. Hey, real talk, you want to go with a shebang? Like, hey, especially if I felt like you tried me a little bit, because I'm one of them dudes. Oh, bro, she always trying me. I'm going to let it loose. Oh, I'm going to play dumb. When I get it, I'm going to goddamn. When I get show up and show out.
I'm going to unleash that monster. Hey, Javar, really quick, though. As long as you're about to take the next topic, though. But before we do, happy birthday to you.
Appreciate that.
Happy birthday to you.
I can't sing. I'm tone deaf.
Happy birthday, Javar. I fucking love you and I appreciate you, bro. Oh,
so thankful for you.
So don't thankful. Disappoint me, Falcons.
Let's go. Dilly dilly.
That was asking a lot for them, huh?
Mm-hmm. Bro, it's
I think she said, hey, I got an idea too, Matt. But I'll talk to you after that later.
Hey, before we get into this next topic, Javar, also, happy anniversary to us working together. It's been a year.
Oh, congratulations.
Yeah, we did that. We remember the Pandy. Oh, no, it's been 2 years. We did the Pandies back in 2020, right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, it's 2020. Because we didn't do it 2021. Mm-mm. So, yeah, happy 2 years, bro.
It's a little past our six-month anniversary.
Yeah, we're almost at that six-month anniversary. We're, like, right there on the cusp.
You got to go crazy for that show. We might go drop a comment if you guys want the live show. If you guys want a live Issa vibe, Maddie's been like trying to like Robbie, do it. Just fucking do it. I want you guys
in the comments. I swear I will bring my A game. I have a couple topics I have in
Here's what we'll do. We will go unscripted. All right. There'll be none of this. We'll go completely unscripted. Episode 24. All right. You have between now and episode 24 to let us know if you guys want us live. You also have to get us to 200 subscribers and you got to get us to 4,000 total views as a whole entire channel. So you have to check out not just us, but also our brothers and sisters on the channel too. All right.
I promise you, we got some good stuff. You're going to want to send this to your situationship.
Exactly.
Let me talk to him.
Let me talk to him. Jabbar, start us off with this one here, bro. So lately, it's been like this crazy weather scheme around like the nation. I know it's pretty boring when people talk about weather, but listen, hear me out. All right. I got something for y'all. Seasonal depression. All right, we got places getting hot one day and then like fucking warm real quick. It's fucked with my seasonal depression. Maddie's in Oklahoma and it's more cold in her place in her state than in my state in Colorado. Like, how do you two deal with this whole seasonal depression shit? Like, is it a thing for you? Do you think it exists? What are some of your coping skills? Help our viewers because they want it.
Move to the southeast.
Maybe Atlanta's my spot. Maybe I'll get Atlanta.
Yeah, it'd be cool, but if it's snowing in Atlanta, it's gonna shut down. Like, man, this little snow, what is this? You're gonna be like that, but Atlanta gonna be like, oh my goodness, what is I can't walk. But I think like in certain areas where it's a drastic change, like in I went for an internship out in Woods Hole. It's Woods Hole, Massachusetts. It's on the coast of Massachusetts. I was on an internship out there, and I was like, bro, y'all ball out for the summer. Like,
yeah,
we supposed to be at work 9 to 5, but certain days, they'd be like, bro, we cooking out at 1. We got wine. Like, these are research. I was there for an internship doing research on corals at the moment. And so we're all research, this institution where everybody do research, and they like, okay, well, for lunch today, we got some wine, we got some, we gonna barbecue, we gonna chill for like the rest of the day. I'm like, word, like, why y'all go so crazy in the summer? They was like, because when the winter comes, all you can do is work up here, bro. Like, you can't do nothing. You don't even want to be outside. You just drive to where you gotta go. You go in there and you stay. So we get a lot of work done in wintertime, because there's nothing there to do. Like, the town had softball tournament where everybody played each other. So, like, biology department played chemistry department.
And I want to see what this game
department
is like.
The fire department, the police department
played.
The U.S. Fishing. It was a softball league. It was cool. The U.S. Fish and Wildlife played. It was like everybody in the town individually played in the softball league. And it was a drink. And softball league, so everybody had their PBRs and you was playing, so it was real cool. Like, yo, you know, I've never been in something like this, so it was real cool. Like, they go crazy in the summer, and then I asked him, I was like, because in the winter it's a dead town, you feel me? So
I just
in towns like that, I can see it being it can be a huge problem. You know, you're going from all this action, then you're going from like not really being able to hang out.
In a snap of a fucking Thanos finger, bro.
Right. So I can see it. I can see it.
Sis, how do you deal with it? I mean, you could definitely relate with a lot of colder country. You and me as well. What's your techniques? How do you get through this time? We're almost at spring. And what's your spring bucket list? Spring and summer bucket list too.
So first of all, yes, I completely experienced it. I think I definitely can feel a shift in like my mental health when I'm not exposed to the sunshine, when I can't get outside and get fresh air. I just kind of feel like I'm drugged down all the time. I don't want to leave. Like, you're in it. And in Oklahoma, we don't just get like cold and like we get the tornadoes. We get all kinds of stuff. We get tornadoes all the time. Yeah. But what sucks is it's just like constant wind. It's like it can be a beautiful day and it's 80-mile wind outside. Like it's just
fuck what?
Oh yeah, like the winds get crazy out here. That's why punters and kickers hate playing at OU. Anyways, different story for a different time. But yeah, so I definitely feel like I go through it. And to me, like the way I manage it is I just stick harder to my systems, my techniques, my tools that I use to deal with my anxiety. And I know things that make me happy. So I make sure that I make time for those every day. And on the other side of things, like I'm gonna be real honest with you. Last year, like I would just dip. Like I go out of state, I do other things on the weekends. So if you have a chance to travel, like that's my best advice.
You don't,
to be honest, I'm trying to get out of Oklahoma. So.
When I used to,
you don't gym when I moved to Missouri and, you know, being from Georgia, I'm not used to the winters like that. When I moved to Missouri, I became like a gym rat. Like I would just like, I would get off for like 3 or 4. I would like, work out, and then I would shoot hoops for like 2 hours. I'm not even a good basketball player, but
I do.
I would hoot for 2 hours.
I think another thing is for me, it's a little bit different because I'm involved. So I'm on the board for one volunteer organization and one big charity, and then I hold a leadership role in another volunteer organization, and then I do outside volunteer stuff. And the volunteer season gets slammed, like it's all right now. Like there's galas every weekend and stuff like that, fundraising events I have to be a part of, and like different meetings. And so I'm so go, like nah, I don't work out in the winter. But in the summer, like longer days, like I feel so good. Like I love to be outside, so I'm always out. Like I'll wake up at 5 and I go run just to be outside and be in the weather, which is probably why my mental health struggles in the winters, because I don't.
You must like cardio. Right. You just said the words run, and I was like, fuck.
I like the endorphin. My favorite thing is a Stairmaster. I like to read on a Stairmaster or watch TV on a Stairmaster.
Oh, wow. The people in Missouri, they would be like, they'd be like, yeah, man. It'd be like 32 degrees or below. They'd be like, yeah, man, we're going 100. Javar, you should come. I'm like, sit in the stand 32 below and wait for a deer to come by. I'm good on that, bro.
These dudes will go break open ponds that are frozen over. It's below freezing, and they sit in the water to go duck
hunting. Ice fishing is a thing out here. I'm like, y'all are fucking weird. What I do to get through my season?
I do it, but I can't do the cold.
I can do the cold. I have this. So I have a couple of things.
Season is during the winter, so I can't.
Yeah.
I got to do it early winter if I do it.
It always bothers me when people take vacations in the cold. Like, why the fuck you wasting your vacation?
Oh.
Ain't nobody happy.
I mean, if you like it, you're going skiing and all that, then that's shooting. That's just
water skiing on a beach. It's beautiful.
What I do is recently I have tried to actually bring up winter sports. I actually did recently start getting back on a snowboard for like the first time since like 17. So that's been pretty dope. That's been pretty fucking cool. Just trying that out. Actually, my board is
that against your expo contract?
You got jokes.
I know, I'm funny.
that was good. I was like, oh shit.
You didn't know how to answer that.
Well, I didn't. No, it's not. I'm still a free agent until
Robbie's been talking mad shit on Twitter. Can you imagine if he pulls a Javar, shows up, can't walk?
Literally weekend after the NFL draft, we're having our camp.
Good luck.
So hey, well,
I'll pull up with drink sign. I got y'all in 2 years. You can call me 10 yards shouty. I'm gonna run a route 10 yards and less. I ain't got time to be playing around with y'all. You know what I'm saying?
Don't line up against
Julian Edelman.
I thought you're, yeah, that's his, yeah.
He's sitting there sucking down his vape, talking about 10 yard.
Oh,
that's it. Hey,
I just took a hit.
15 yards.
For our non football listeners, that's the equivalent of a 2-pump chump.
Oh, fuck.
Hey, people live right there. Hey, Julian Edelman was MVP of Super Bowl. Right, running them yards. You feel
your last resort option on the field.
Cole Beasley making a killing out there in Buffalo, running them 10 yards.
Exactly. And you girls look up Cole Beasley. Crazy. You know that. Right.
But nah, I've been picking up snowboarding lately, you know, to like fuck around, have some fun. Let's see. The gym, like Javar said. The gym during the winter time, like even if you're not a gym bro, I hate saying that term because like Amar is literally a gym bro. Like he is the
is a gym bro.
Yeah, he is the definition of a gym bro. Like I'd be like, yo, what are you doing? He's like, I'm at the gym.
We start at the same time every week, and every week Amar, where are you? I'm at the gym. My bad. We starting y'all. Same exactly. time every week.
I became just as bad because like when a lot of my friends are texting me lately, I'm like, I'm at the gym. There's nothing wrong with going to the gym every day, like if that's your thing. But like if it helps you get over your seasonal depression, I do recommend it. I call it zoo therapy because you're just in there throwing around weights. I mean, you're throwing around weights properly, obviously, like use proper form, use proper technique. I get that.
I'm in love with a stripper. She Jafar's up there just like.
Sorry,
I got distracted.
Other than that, keep yourself entertained. Like because you're gonna be indoors a lot of the time. Like if you're not indoors at the gym, like whenever you're not, you know, doing that or doing like an outdoor like activity like snowboarding or snowball fighting like your girl or something like that. Fucking, you know.
Snowball fighting your girl. Robbie, I've been watching the Hallmark Channel.
I just came up with that off the top of my head and I might now do it. Build a snowman with her, do some cute ass shit, you know, get some brownie points.
Build a snowman in the street. What was that commercial they took off real quick? The little girl the snowman out of the freezer.
It was a Campbell's chicken noodle soup.
She built a snowman and kept it in the freezer over the whole year, then put it out on the street, and then somebody just come and run right over it. And I only seen that commercial like one or two times, bro. They took that commercial out quick.
It hit in Oklahoma because I've seen it a few times.
Wow, okay.
aside from that, find like a hobby. For me, everyone knows this. One of my hobbies is stand-up comedy. I really love stand-up comedy. I really love art. So if I am gonna go out, you know, in this,
you really love what was that?
I just proved your point. Fuck my life.
I really like art.
I really like
And you know he's passionate about a topic whenever the accent comes out because he's not regulating it.
I really like art.
You can always tell the girls that he likes too because of the way he talks. When he starts getting that accent. So if you're fucking with Robbie, if you're on the roster and you hear him start talking about my shoddy, you wanna go look at some art with me? Whatever he's got going on. When he starts pulling out that accent, you got the number one spot, girl. So if that's you.
You know, I like girls with attitude. I like girls with a lot of confidence. I like girls with a lot of swagger. Like to be honest. But no.
What else you got?
Aside from that, getting into something, you know, binge worthy that like you both can enjoy. Speaking of binge worthy stuff, let's get into that. The first thing that I'm gonna recommend is for those of you that spent fucking $200 to get that Kanye album tonight at midnight. Binge that shit because you spent $200 on it, you dumbass, for Donda 2. I'm not doing that, just so that we know. Even though my tweet about
you're gonna be on this next list.
I dare you. But also Euphoria. Like if you have not watched Euphoria, get in on Euphoria. Like that shit is
kind of triggering to me. I couldn't get past the first episode.
I watched like three or four seasons. My best friend is like, yo, you caught up on Euphoria. I'm like, man, it'd be so drugged up and it just be like it's a lot of downer. So I just like, man, I don't know. I might have to watch one show a week.
once you get past that, the people that I'm a fan of, like the storyline I'm a fan of. Is the homie Fez and Ashtray?
That's how I see everybody love that guy. Yeah,
bro.
Redhead guy.
No, Ashtray's a little 15.
No, but who's the redhead guy? Yeah, Fez. You're right. That's the first person you said. But yo, everybody love him.
Yo, Ashray's little brother, Ashray is 15, and he a little gangster, bro. Like, yo, all I'm going to say is everyone that has watched Euphoria, okay, for my Euphoria crowd, this next episode coming up, let a single scratch happen to Fezco or Ashray. We fucking riot, all right? We go crazy. We fucking lose it, bro. Like that. Hey, I'm gonna be honest. That show is fire. That one. And I am just now starting. BMF. Shout out to the homie Lil Meat. Shout out Big Meat. I am getting into BMF. Shout out 50 for putting that
BMF
on. Yeah, BMF is on Stars. So
like, yeah, I talked about this, but it's not called. Is it called something else?
No, it's BMF. No, yeah. BMF.
50 got like 3 or 4 shows on Stars. So he got Ghost, then he got Force, then he got some other stuff. He got BMF.
What's the one about the club owner?
That's Power.
Yeah. That's Power.
That's
yeah.
pretty good too.
Yeah. Fired. 50 doing his thing though. Shout out to 50. You know, I love people who like transition, especially people from the culture transition from doing something.
This man and go to music, something else.
So it kind of pushes me to just see somebody, you know, take on another step after, you know, they came out of music. You're like, no, I ain't just music. And they show they can do something else. Shout out to Mary J. Blige. I ain't just music. I'm acting too. You know, they take a second step in their career, you know, just kind of motivate me. Just no matter how old you get, you can also transition something new and make a new way for yourself. So, you know, I just love seeing that. Shout out to 50, man. Real talk.
Yo, Javar, you just, would you say, and Maddie, you can even, you know, would you say that we on some 50 shit right here? I mean, we are, at the end of the day, fantasy football analysts, and we are doing this shit.
Yeah.
We also 50 shit. Like, we also 50
stay
shit.
Stay open-minded. You gotta stay open-minded.
Let me drop a shoe. Maddie, Javar. Your binge-worthy shows. Javar actually put me on to one. I think that he's going to say it.
I'm just here so I don't get fined.
Iconic as fuck. That was so iconic.
Hey, that's one of my favorite. Hey, right. Hey, that's one of my favorite moments alongside you mediocre at best. Don't you ever try me. Don't you ever try me. Hey, those two are up there, bro. When Richard Sherman said it, I was so hyped. My father called me. It was like he was so disrespectful. I'm like, bro, this is football. That man up there arguing with somebody the whole game, going back and forth.
We're talking about game,
right?
We're talking about practice.
Practice, the Allen Iverson one.
Practice,
right, bro? Like they've been talking shit the whole game, and he made the play to win the game, and he hyped, bro. This is football. Yeah. This aggressive. He said that probably he wanted to be more mild. But the reporter came right in his face after the moment. Like, what you expecting? He gonna be hyped. Like, yeah, talking all that junk all game. You mediocre at best. Like, he should be disrespectful.
My favorite is you play.
And now he a Hall of Famer. Richard Sherman, probably a Hall of Famer. Other guy, he is mediocre at best. And I love Michael Crabtree from Texas Tech all the way to the league. That was my guy. So when Richard Sherman said that about him, I was hyped. Like, oh, yo, this is football. That was one of my favorite moments in front of Mike for football.
Passion.
Right, you just seen it. It was live. You felt it. Like, ooh, this is gritty. Insight. I love it. I love it.
When it was the you play to win the game line, that line literally changed my whole fucking life. Like Herm Edwards with that line. Like I remember that press conference in those years. Like they were doing pretty decent with Chad Pinson at their quarterback. And when he said that, I was sitting back in the kitchen. My dad had picked us up for the weekend, you know, fucking typical ass custody orders and shit. And sitting back eating, and we're watching the little ass TV in the kitchen. My grandma, shout out to my grandma, mi abuela on my dad's side. She had like the old school little tiny TV in the kitchen. Y'all remember those? Mm-hmm. With the antennas and shit, like the rabbit ears. And he comes on TV and he's in his presser. And he's like, losing? Losing? You play to win the game. You play to win the game. And
lose the game.
Oh,
you feel me?
What up, Brian Flores? Are we football analysts or what?
Exactly, exactly. All of our football following is just like, and then all of our non-football following is like,
we lost them. They're really let's get back to fuck buddies and friends with benefits.
Hold on. We have 48.4% of you guys that are literally viewing our content and are not subscribed. Hit the damn button. Just hit the fucking button for real. Just, it takes 5 seconds.
Just hit it. The button been hit.
I was hoping that Javar, you were going to mention Righteous Gemstones. Maddie.
Oh, yeah. That's pretty funny. Righteous Gemstones.
I've been on Righteous Gemstones.
Yeah, I've been watching. It's just wild. The comedy, like, what's called McBride? He got a couple of shows. Vice Principal is on HBO Max. Vice Principal was funny.
I haven't seen that.
It's with him and Baby Billy. And they be going on riots. Hey, brother. It's like two seasons on that. It's mild version of Gemstone. You know, it's kind of mild. Yeah. And then McBride, he got the other one. What's the first one he made on HBO? Eastbound and Down. Now that was hella wild.
So good,
bro. Hey, that was some guys introduced me to sit at a Missouri. And, you know, I'm looking at it like, bro, what is he saying, bro?
What the fuck is this?
Right. So yeah. But yeah, I gotta go with it. I like. I just caught up on the Godfather of Harlem is with Forrest Whitaker. He's playing Bumpy Johnson, and then they got Michael Max. No, is he playing?
Yeah, I think he's playing Bumpy Johnson.
Right. And then they got Michael Max in there. It's wild. I was feeling that. That's good. And Wu Tang is wild too. Just to know, like, what diversity.
Yeah, we brought that up before.
What they came, what they went through to become a group, like, that's wild. Like, that's some real Cinderella story type shit. And then, you know, and then they put it, and then it's going to be a season 3, so that's where they do the binge watch, and then you can catch up and watch season 3 with everybody, you feel me? So, yeah, those two I wanted to mention for sure, though. You know, it's a whole bunch of stuff. I can go all day on Netflix about some science fiction shows. You know, on Netflix, I can go wild.
Shit.
Like, I don't really watch the documentary, but that's science fiction. Where I love it.
Did you watch the Juice WRLD documentary?
Nah. Oh, that's
I cried.
So wait. All right. I'm gonna need. We just gonna start binging shit. It's the off season. We just binging shit. Aside from film.
That's the thing. Shit. It's like we came out of season, so we've been watching. You guys watch football on Sundays. We watch football on Sundays, and we're bringing down film Sunday, Monday, talking about it Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, doing it all over again. Like, that's what we have to eat, breathe, sleep. Like, we don't have time to do anything else. I'll be on the pot freaking watching film. Propped up whenever I'm in the bathtub, like, watching film. Like I ingest so much football that, like, my brain can't function on other
So
things.
How do you get a break? What are you watching to get a break?
Well, okay. So, I like to watch a lot of chick flick stuff. Like, I like...
You get your chick flicks.
You like Ashton Kutcher movies?
Yeah,
she gets good chick flicks.
The one he did with Bernie Mac.
No strings. Something daughter. It's who
I forgot. But yeah, that was pretty funny.
No strings attached is good. Okay, but HBO Max, Issa. I always forget the name. Insecure.
Yeah, that's
so
hella funny.
Good. It's so funny. It's like you don't
that's
have
the
to
second
like.
Time
like
you
can
recommend
like.
That.
Yeah, it's so.
Bro,
good.
It's like, hella funny. You can watch that with a chick.
You can watch it with that's.
You can watch it alone too.
I watched it with my friends with benefits guy, my dude, number one roster spot. Like that was kind of like we watched.
Me and wifey watched it together. It's
so
a good show
good.
To watch together. Yeah. It's hella funny.
It is. It's so good.
Awkward situations that are hella funny.
Yeah. Righteous Gemstones is good. I'm really excited. It hasn't come out yet, but Winning Time. It hits in March. It's about the rise of the Lakers dynasty.
I've seen it.
Fucking good. Yeah.
That looks March 6th. Matter of fact.
Yeah, they premiered it during
the
Super Bowl,
the Magic
and everybody lost their shit.
No,
it's the whole Lakers dynasty.
Right.
It takes them through all of it. I'm so excited. It's going to be good. And then also, I haven't watched it yet. Heard reviews. If you like Euphoria, Bel Air. which is the remake of Fresh Prince.
You're the like.
I haven't seen it yet, but
yeah, that's not. What is that? That's on Epic. That's on what?
Peacock. But it's like $4 a month. But I will say my number one spot. My number one spot was like, no, I'm not watching that because like it's not real. Like Carlton's doing drugs. No, Carlton doesn't do drugs. He's a square. He was so
they just flipped everybody. Wow.
If you grew up on Fresh Prince, like I think it's like the new Gossip Girl, right? It's not the same. It's the same name. It's to fit Gen Z, right? So I think you have to go into it with that mindset. Like it's not going to be the same as what we loved as kids.
Oh, I want to mention another show. Oh, the new Gossip Girl. I want to mention another show. I watched Ted. I watched all of Ted. It's on Apple TV. Some of the actors I don't really know, and some of the lines are kind of dry. But like, it feels like no matter what they went through, every episode you felt you left happy. Whatever they did that with the writing, every episode that you watch a Ted, you just kind of left happy, like just like you, your person, like the way they drawn up to end each show. So that was kind of interesting, and it was cool. It had some funny moments. So Ted is a good show that it gets you upbeat and feeling good.
And that's an art. That's an art form. That's an art form, honestly, within itself. Damn, I don't think I have anything else to sprinkle onto that. Aside from,
I told you I don't want to go crazy because I go crazy. Lock and Key on Netflix go crazy. Bones on Netflix go. I think it's something before Bones, but that go crazy. It's a lot of science fiction shows on Netflix that go crazy, bro.
I'll say this: definitely check out the documentary scene. I'm a big person on that. I'm a Gemini. I'm stimulated off of intellectual shit. You know, that's just the way that I am. I'm like one of those weird ass people. Definitely check out the documentary scene. I know there's a couple of good ones coming out. Definitely check out the stand up comedy scene.
Yeah, I'm check out Kanye. I'm hearing about Kanye.
Kevin. Yeah, yo, that Donda 2 from the music standpoint.
No, I was talking about Tommy's documentary on Netflix.
He does have a documentary on
Netflix. Everybody being raving about that. Even J. Cole posted something about that. He appreciate it. So I'm a huge J. Cole fan. So if he's saying, like, appreciate the artwork, the insights, I got to check that out.
It's Cole World.
Shout out to him, man. Yeah, I mean, even though what he's doing with Kim K and all that, cool, you know, you can calm down a little bit. I don't know the whole situation, but yeah.
That motherfucker, wow. Shit. Hey, but you know what? At the end of the day, all I can say about that situation is he black, so I gotta have his back. Until that motherfucker snap, I can't take him to chiropractic. So, you know, shit. That shit is wild, though. Let's go ahead. Let's wrap up. Let's get into some outros. Let's talk about what folks have. I don't know if I want to talk about what we have coming up next or, like, if we want to leave with, like some advice or something. Just say something random. Just do something random that's not the norm. Like, if you want to give advice or whatever, I don't care. Let's start with Maddie. Ladies first.
I love that he's like, do something different. Maddie, you're up.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like I've already spoken my truth tonight. I've touched some souls.
Show up. That's what she said. Show the fuck up. You only here for one thing.
If you're gonna commit, yeah. If you're gonna commit, like in anything in life, like if you are going to put your name on it, if you're gonna be that person, show the fuck up. Show up for yourself, for your name, for your legacy. Hell, show up for the next person. You know what I mean? Like this is why all these girls are bitches out here. Because you have to deal with bad dick and shitty dudes. Like you don't add to the problem.
Maddie, let me tell you a quick story. You get recommended
at Maddie Kroll.
You can get recommended. I had this one girl who I used to mess with. She was like, yeah, are you still in Missouri? I was like, what you talking about? She was like, oh, I got this friend. You know, I'm taking right now, so I don't need anything. But I got this friend and she needs some company. I'm like, wait. So somebody I used to, you know, show up and hang out with, she recommended me to somebody, like, yeah, hey, yeah, he'll show up. So fucking, I was like, yo, what is this?
Secondhand.
Right. What is this? So I was like, I'm glad I'm out of town. This feels kind of weird, bro.
I hate that. This
feels kind of weird, bro. This feels kind of weird. Like, oh, yeah.
Jabari just passed up on a threesome.
Hey, there's something
damn.
Like
that. Hey, don't tell me that, man.
I'm just joking. I'm just fucking. Damn.
This is funny, right?
Be nice. Follow me at Matty Kroll. Shavar, you're next.
Yeah.
I'm going to start with.
I'm happy start birthday. With. Everybody happy follow birthday. Javar tomorrow and tell him happy birthday. Or today. Ooh, today. Follow him today and tell him happy birthday.
Bye. Yes, appreciate it. I don't know, like Maddie said, show up, man. I just speak on unless something's going through. I got deadlines to reach and I got things to do, man. And it can bring a little anxiety. Think about it every day. So just like. Find your scapegoat, find your way to relax, find a healthy way, even if it's just, you know what I'm saying, read a book or read something different, just anything you can. Me, it's more so, you know, just laughing at my daughter. You know, she can bring me joy just laughing at her, seeing her growing. She can bring me a lot of anger, bless too. But, you know, I like to get on the video game, shoot a couple people on Call of Duty just to relieve a couple of stress. So, you know, just find your scapegoat to keep you level, man, to keep you, you know, keep you going every day to where you don't just bust and, yeah.
Or just bust.
Yeah, you know, when you just bust. No,
try not
like,
to
where you just either. Where you just bust like Kanye West when he just beat up the guy for one on the autograph, you know, maybe a lot of things just been going through him. He just reacted that one more, you know, so just try to find your scapegoat so that don't happen to you. And you keep it easy and keep it going, making you money. And don't nothing hurt you. You feel me? So blessings all around. And the words of my man, Marshawn Lynch, you know what I'm saying? Protect your mental, protect your chicken. You feel me?
Fair.
I'm gonna head out. Right. I'm gonna head out with that. You know, I'm only here so I won't get fined.
Okay, we all here just so we don't get fined, ladies and gentlemen. Listen. I'm going to light this incense for a little bit of spiritual cleansing. You dig what I'm saying now? Hey, I want to leave y'all with this. Be happy. Love each other. Be kind. Be peaceful. Be joyful. Listen, motherfucker, life is too short for any of you to be on some hating ass so fast. What the fuck is this person doing ass? How the fuck is this person working with this person ass? Type of bullshit, okay?
A lot of ass.
A lot of ass that a lot of y'all motherfuckers may or may not be getting, okay? Listen, I'm going to keep it real because this is the deal. You already feel what I'm saying, okay? I'm going to keep playing. Be pushing P out here.
Okay.
Listen. You can hate on me. I will
step
never.
On digs.
Hold on. You can hate on me. I'll never hate on you. All right. Try and play me. Listen, you already played yourself, my dude. But at the end of the day, I'm going to be about my hustle. I'm going to keep my pockets on full muscle like I already put them in the body bag of the duffel. You know what I'm saying? Okay. Treat people with kindness. Do right amongst others. Love yourself, because if you love yourself first, it's a lot easier to love everyone else. Riches is not about dollars. It's about the way that you spread your spiritual and emotional wealth. Like he said, protect your mental, protect your chicken. Don't be out here giving out bad dickens. I'm just spitting this real slicking. You dig what I'm saying? This has been this.
Show up. You know
show
what I'm saying?
We keep it.
If you don't walk through the door, show up.
This has been a survive. This has been a survive.
You hate when your favorite team tribe. Don't show up, so you yeah. need to show up.
And share. Share this show so that your shitty situationship, the dude that you need to step up and be a better friend to benefits, share this so his ass listens.
Hey.
Let's educate the public, y'all.
Tonight was a beautiful show. We push a P, ladies and gentlemen. Cheers pushing to me. P. Cheers I'm to you.
With my strength, I'm pushing P.
Pushing P. Cheers to me. Cheers to you. Shout out to the Vibe Tribe. What it do? 2 Chainz. 2 Chainz. Take us away.
Yeah, that's a vibe. She wanna vibe. That's a vibe. It's a vibe. Yeah, yeah. Late night. Oh, it's a vibe. Let me slide. Oh, it's a vibe. Yeah.